What is up, you guys? Happy freaking Friday. Your girl does not want to be here, but she's here and she's going to hit the gym. Little bit shoulders here. I procrastinated for 4 hours to get to the gym. So learn from my mistake and do not fucking procrastinate. Get your ass out of your bed and get to work out. I'll see you inside. My shoulders are not feeling it today. All right, y'all. Third set here. I started the first set with 25s. Shoulders were really tight. Moved down to 2 10s. Feeling pretty good here. Probably gonna do another set of 25. Going right in super sad with these front raises. Don't know if it's gonna be on the video, but let's see. One more set. So, next thing we're up with is some Smith Machine shoulder press. Already did 3 sets. This is my 4th one, super setting with the cable side raises. Started with a 10 pound and a 5. Slightly moved the weight up to a 25. That was about to go horribly wrong if it wasn't a Smith machine. That's 5 pounds. Add a lot of weight to it. So this is our 3rd set here, and we're going to superset it with our face pulse seated. We just added a little bit more weight here, about 10 more pounds. Goal is to always keep the tension in our rear delt. Whenever I say tension is not bad. It's about keeping your mind and muscle connected so you're feeling that stretch and you're squeezing. You're not letting it go like this where you have to reset again and it's gonna bother your posture. Keeping your shoulders down and away. That's what it is. I'm gonna do one more set after this and probably gonna do some side lateral raises with dumbbells for about 2 sets just to, I guess, rep it out and burn it out. But that's about it. I'd be thinking, what the fuck is she doing? I learned about it myself 2 years ago about running the rack. You're not going all the way out, but your focus is your side delts. Try and do as many as you can. Oh, that gives you a burnout. Fuck. We're done with the workout. Okay, you guys, your girl is freaking done. Like I said, get your ass up, go to the gym, get that shit done. See, there's no point in procrastinating. Once you're done, you're gonna feel freaking good. Think about that time where you're gonna get out of the gym and you're gonna be like, I fucking did it. I'm not gonna feel like a piece of shit today. Not that you should, but you're not. Okay, I already explained that. But other than that, the workout went really freaking good. Started with some regular ass shoulder press machine work that I usually do and went right in with supersetting front raises. Did front raises with the shoulder press machine and then went in with Smith machine. I've been wanting to do Smith machine and honestly, I think I'm gonna incorporate it a little bit more than usual. I thought I was about to hear a honk. It was coming fast. Anyways. So I'm gonna incorporate more of a Smith machine, but I did total 5 sets of a Smith machine because I felt good and I actually wanted to record an Instagram video. I have been recording Instagram videos and never posting it. To be honest with you, I need to start being more active because I'm so busy in life with 2 jobs right now. I think I'm using it as an excuse. I need to put my shit together. Anyways, after that, we supersided that with the cable side raises and moved right into some rear delts. Face pulls with flies. That combo I just love. And then ended with running the rack for twice. I did, started with 25s because your girl was not about to lift 30 or more. So start with 25s. You'll see I'm going slightly up, not all the way up. That's because that's where running a rack is. You're trying to lift as heavy as you can, just feeling the side of your delts pulling. And you're going down by numbers. Last time I did it was basically 2 years ago, I think, with my workout partner back then. His coach has made him do run the racks on shoulder days with this almost the same exercise that we did. But I got to share that shoulder workout with you guys. That shit was lit. That shit have you pumped. That's for the days that you have too much energy and do the work, okay? So maybe next week we're going to hit something like that. But the shoulder the run the rack, his coach had him do hundreds and then 90s, 80s. I was like, fuck no, and 10 each rep. Yeah, that was not gonna happen with me. So I was just copying his workout when I was working out with him. So did almost the same workout. Why the fuck such a big line for McDonald's? Like, are they having a buy one, get one free? Shaking my head. I would never go McDonald's ever again unless I want McFlurry. But then I have seen so much roach videos in there. Ugh. Makes me feel disgusted. Unless I know the place I'm going to is legit clean. Other than that, no, I'm not. But other than that, we ended with the Run the Racks, and that is it. I did a little posing. I felt so fat. My cellulite was showing through the camera, showing through the light. That light was trash in the posing room. I didn't mess around with it because I just didn't want to mess around at that moment. Kind of felt big. But good news is coming. I don't know exactly when it's starting. I think Monday I'm definitely starting, but you guys, I don't still know what to name the freaking series. But leave a comment below what you think my next series should be. It's a cut. It's still cut. I'm so glad you guys couldn't hear that much, because that shit was loud. It's a cut. I'm still cutting, but it's under supervision. So put two and two together and comment below what my next series should be called, because I just don't want to call it Cut Day One. Because if you know, you know. If you're smart enough, you figure it out. So leave the comment below, okay? Other than that, I hope you guys enjoy your workout, enjoy your fucking cardio. Also, I didn't mention, but I did 10 minutes of cardio on that stairs, okay? Get yours in. But I will see you tomorrow.